Welcome to the second part of 6 methods to join strings in an Excel sheet. In the last video, we have seen how to join strings using concatenate function and ampersand operator. In this video, two macros and a user-defined function for joining strings are explained. In the last video, we have seen how to join strings using concatenate function and ampersand operator. In this video, we will see how to join text using macros and user-defined functions. Go to VBA editor, insert a module. I will name this macro as join strings. Declare in memory xl and cat as range. When a variable is declared as range object, it can be used to refer cells or a range of cells in an Excel sheet. Then another variable sonder as range. Then xnc as string. Set xl and cat equal selection. Whatever we select in our worksheet will be stored into the variable xl and cat. Then a for loop for each sonder in xl and cat. Xnc equal xnc ampersand double quotes space ampersand sonder. In the first iteration of the loop, first item in the selection will be concatenated to the string called xnc. As you can see here, xnc is not assigned with any values, and after first iteration, value of xnc will be the value of first item in our selection. And after the second iteration, value of xnc will be first item space second item in our selection. And when all iterations are over, all the strings present in our selection will be combined into a single string xnc. Next, to close the loop. Now for printing the value of xnc into a cell, active cell dot offset 0 comma 1 dot select selection dot value equal xnc, and I want to display this sentence in bold format, selection dot font dot bold equal true. Back to our worksheet. I will assign this macro to a command button. Now I will make a selection. We'll execute the macro. And we have combined all those words present in the selection into a single sentence. Now with a different data set. That is data present in horizontal direction. For combining this data, I will copy this code and paste it here. We'll change the name of the macro. Active cell dot offset 1 comma 0 dot select. Back to our worksheet. We'll assign the macro to a command button. Now select the data. Click on the button to execute the macro. Once again, and we have combined the data present in horizontal direction into a single sentence. Now about a user-defined function for combining text present in different cells. Those who are not familiar with user-defined functions in Excel, please watch my video on the same. Go to VBA editor, insert a module. I will name this function as xnc, xl and cat as range. Declare in memory sonder as range. Now a for loop. The statements inside the for loop are the same which we used for creating that macro. Back to our worksheet. I am going to combine the text present in the cells B2, C2 and D2. Equal x. When I type x, the newly defined function is shown in the suggestions. Equal xnc. I have to specify the range of cells inside the function B2 to D2, and we have combined the text present in the range of cells from B2 to T2. We can do it in vertical direction tool. Select cell B7 equal XNC B2 to B5. Concat function and text join function for joining strings will be explained in third video. For feedback and discussion, please make use of the comment section. And those who are visiting this channel for the first time, subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon so that you won't miss any video releases. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.